Well, hello everybody, welcome back to episode 44 of my Let's Play of none other than Banner Saga Ferrari. I'm IVATOPIA, and it looks like we finally have the proper party that we should have in this part of the game, because it seemed to flip for some reason, I don't know why. Again, if you put it in the comments and explained why in the last episode or the episode before, thank you very much. As I was recording these, I was doing the exact same night, practically straight after each other, with the odd break between. So that's why I'm still clueless what happened, even if you've already given me the answer and explained how it fitted into the story a week or two ago for me. If you did, thank you very much. And it's very much appreciated, even though at the moment, as recording this, I'm still baffled why it did it. Story-wise, it didn't fit, so... I mean, you got a very story-driven game. And... think about it, logically. We spent... well, in our band, the main group party, Rook's party, was in there. Had to have so many days or else all darkness hits them. It hit zero, the darkness hit them. So logically, they should be dead or somehow fighting for their lives or being twisted or with what's the name trying to keep their small light on them like we have. But we don't exactly know what's going on. That's supposed to be what's going on and something on that line. Where we took 22 days, that's right, 22 days to get to this darkness. Walking and separated from them. And then I rang a bell. And all of a sudden, we're all surrounded. Rook's defending that very bell. So he's back at Arabran defending a bell that I rung. So I rung again and it affected Arabran. Makes no sense. But then after the fight, Ivor and them are talking, the Ravens having a chat with each other. And then as we're continuing, it's everyone from Arabran. So somehow, in their so-called destruction, they've, you know, with a click of a finger, 22 days caught up with us. And when it comes to fight, I couldn't use the actual ravens. And it made no logical sense. Is it inside his head? Are they dead and it's in his head? Like, how? And now also in this chapter, ravens walking again. And Rook and them who helped last chapter aren't even there. It's like, what's going on? Anyway, let's carry on. Maybe it explains at the end and I'm just reading too much into it. Serpent raises its tattered head to the tower top. It speaks in an ancient tongue as before. Be gone, creature. You don't even have the strength to crush this tower anymore. Serpent continues its low, undulating speech, like smoke rolling over seawater. Ivan stops. He's listening. Ivan. Go for savour. What does it want? It is giving up. It wants to make a deal. Half a prophecy of extinction, it says. What? The darkness will live and it will spare Arabran. It consumes only half the world. Half the world is changed for what? Juno's energy. If I release it to the serpent, Juno will be gone, but she won't suffer. You can tell her and it's seriously considering it. You can tell. Okay, so let's get this straight. Our choices are... okay, let me read them and then we'll work out choices. Ivan, this isn't what we came to do. No, I won't let you do this. Going to trust this... Okay, so it's basically if I decide to let Ivan do it or not. But basically, so what he's suggesting is, if we come this way to kill him, and then she'd be internally in agony, but all the darkness would be lifted. Or we kill it, and there might be a way to not make her die in eternal agony. We don't 100% know. That was our little plan earlier. But he's saying, you give me half of the world, let me have a Juno, she won't suffer, I get the power, I get half the world, and I will spare Aragorn. What we want, but then what about the other half of the world, people who aren't in Arabon, and what's stopping him going against his word and killing everything? No, I won't let you do this. I don't trust that, not this stage. It's out of your hands now, Ivor. Not while I have this axe. Ivor returns his attention to you with anger on his face. Behind him, the serpent rattles in frustration at being ignored. Don't you understand what is happening here? How could I? It's been nothing but lies and secrets since we first met. What choice did I have? Try to imagine if I told you the truth when we met. It was hard enough convincing everyone to listen in the first place. Back in Sigilhorn, when I begged you to wait for Juno, how long did you wait? Not even a single day. I do remember that vaguely, he wanted us to wait and... I do remember, but I probably didn't, and I can't remember the reason why. It must be something important, probably. And that after all I did in Arison to save the vow from complete extinction. No, if you knew the truth, you'd have drowned me in the lake yourself. I couldn't even trust you to save yourself. So you will decide who is to be saved? How were we supposed to know what was going on? Trust, all of this was your doing. Definitely. You think I don't know that? What's the point of this either? So brothers and clansmen can keep killing each other over and over and over petty disputes?
Wow.
So basically he is talking like he's a god and we're pathetic mortals under him, a bit like she said. So Val and Dredge can go on destroying each other over ancient history? Even after we realised the Dredge were only fleeing the darkness, same as the rest of us. Even after discovering a Dredge child dying in the snow, an infant, everyone was ready to slaughter it like a pig. Yet we didn't. Yet we brought Dredge with us. Yet Rook opened the doors to let them in. And yet the Dredge child lives on even now. We overcame that fear. Can you ask for more than that? You'd rather sink the whole ship than try to patch the hole. And the Dredge child lives on even now. So maybe 1 in 1,000 is spared. Is this really what you want to argue right now? If you're going to ask me to weigh the fate of the world against Juno, then tell me why I should care.
Wow.
So he's putting one person's life above everybody else's in the whole wide world. I can understand that. But the thing is, by doing what you're doing, the thing is more powerful. She's gone anyway, so you still lose her. So she's still gone. And then he just turns around and destroys the whole world anyway. There's no way of stopping it. So, you're going to kill her anyway. Just what would be painless versus hanging everyone else. And Juno wants this. Well, she didn't want it, but she knows what has to be done. Serpent slithers anxiously. It's not accustomed to being ignored, but Iron continues on its spite of the danger. And we both know how this world really is. Remember, Delian's Godstone. That old woman lies to our faces about who attacked who. Then she mocks us for not butchering that stone hurler on sight. And even with that truth laid so bare before us, there was a debate. How can we hope to overcome that kind of spite and ignorance, that hatred? What are we fighting so hard to preserve exactly? You had plenty of time to ask that stone hurler how she feels about it. I will continue to hope until the day there is nothing to hope for. I might agree if it were all nothing but mystery. I will continue to hope until the day there's nothing to hope for. I know you believe that, but you don't know the depths of it the way I do. There was a woman near Arrows and River after we somehow survived crossing the chasm. Some of her own clansmen had tied her to a stake, which, they screamed, she was meant to starve to death. I can still see her face, the torture and the pain. Do you remember how many days she had hung there, starving before we arrived? 3 days. Whenever I remember, this proves nothing. Remember that she was not left there to die, thanks to us. 3 days will answer the question. So they told us. Maybe those men lied, or with the sun stopped, maybe they miscounted. She had been there at least 7 days already. I could feel her agony in the tapestry. According to their own absurd rules, it proves she wasn't a witch. She should have been freed. Can you imagine suffering like that for a world that doesn't even remember you? That's what this is about, isn't it? This is about Juno. I'm not trying to make everything about Juno. I just need to believe in what I'm supposed to do. Ivan seems to be swayed by your arguments. The claws of the serpent are wrapping tighter around the tower, and you can feel its patient growing thin. And it seems to be swayed. It says seems to be swayed. Okay, so not swayed. When we found Juno's body smashed and broken in the frozen sea, I saw that same fate for her as that poor woman starving to death, suffering alone and forgotten. Everyone else was so quick to give up on her. I'm grateful that you did not, but that's what you're asking me to do now. I must sound pathetic, I realise it has to be hard to sympathise, but maybe of all people you can either. When you stood against Bellow on the bridge at Elfton, I finally recognised you and I knew what you had done to raise his child. He followed us both to Burskun to finish the job. What would you give to have her altar back? Don't make Juno suffer an even worse fate, please, either. Trust me to find a solution. It turns back to the serpent, his body radiating immense power as he speaks to it again. Ava gives you a serve look, as if to say, he lies. Oh, she's back, is she? When did she get back? You recall her plan to complete the ritual in place of Arvin. If you're going to do something, it has to be an Alcrat. Trust Arvin and wait. Strike down Arvin, leaving the ritual to Alphen. Then this isn't what Juno wanted. Fudge. He's gone a bit crazy. And he even said there's madness in the males on their section. Years flash before your eyes, and it's the things you know about Juno and Elven, the sacrifice you made, the ones you've lost. All this hardship, it won't be in vain.
For all our foresight, it was putting trust in my allies that doomed him. I watched with horror as Ivan was cut down. The energy spiraled from Alfred's control. But somehow, she has succeeded, despite her own destruction.
She killed herself.
Why it ended this way, I will never know. And I can only wonder if those still in Arboring will know my sacrifice here.
So we did.
I won't give up on them.
The right thing.
Even if all that remains is a memory. Goodbye, Ivan. My love.
I can't believe she said destroy herself. But she died too. I guess I couldn't trust him at the end, because he was gonna do the half-half thing. We need that to come completely. Hope I did the right thing. I didn't want to kill him. But then again, if I just knocked him down and knocked him unconscious, he might have survived, maybe. Maybe I just did that, didn't kill. Journey's end. So we done it. Oh, that's Rook and them. So that's back at Arabon, isn't it? See, they're miles away, so how was I showing them earlier? Oh, we're done! Okay, so was it the ending? Okay, so let me get straight. I stopped the darkness. She's now internal pain. But she stopped the darkness. I might have killed Ivan in the process. Araban looks kind of destroyed, but everyone seems to be alive. I'm a little confused. I think I saved the world. Because theoretically, that thing's dead. The darkness has been lifted. I kind of wanted the game to go a bit more into the people like, who's left. What did he do after? Like, Rook went on to find happiness with whoever. Or Thingy died during the chaos of Arbor 4, but he's... You know what I'm saying? I kind of feel they need to do that. Okay, maybe they are loading. Oh, here we go. Good. Whew! So say don't end like that. Somehow I knew they would do it. Okay, what's left though? Whatever it is. But the sun's actually moving again. For a long time, things were looking pretty hopeless. I'm definitely the oldest at this point. Okay, so these are alive. Again, they were inside the darkness with them not long ago, and that confused me. Hopefully explain that. The gods are dead, the world turned to dust, and we go. So Rook survived. So what do we do now? Are we all that's left? Not all of us. Okay, all we all left. Look at it. Hopefully they'll give me who's left. It's not just these, is it? I don't think so. Okay, good. Life will return. Grass and green will spout the dust. Because so far, these four are different lives. Even through Araban, it's gone, so we did lose Araban. I believe there are other survivors. Val in the north, perhaps huddled around godstones. South of the darkness, there may still be horseborn fleeing across the fields, or ships of men, or dredged without Sundren. So we rebuild. I just wish Alta could be here to see this. I have a feeling she did see it somehow. For a long time now, I've been thinking of an epic poem. You never guess the inspiration. Would you care to hear what I've got? It would be pleasant. I guess I have to. That didn't give me no choice. Al smiles and draws his lute from around his back. He sings with a brightness in his voice. Huh? He sings with a brightness in his voice. I guess a brightness within his voice? because that makes no sense otherwise. When his son has stopped, cut with keen-edged sword. Little did they sleep, least they not come home. Weary the weight of the sun, of our bones, the hills, the slayer and the slain. From their homes must all flee, and they cast their horn into the air, to speak to all tongues. Where a foe may lurk, the destination day shall come. The fetters will burst, brothers fight and kingship stain, and in fear quake all. The true hero comes reluctantly, raising high their shining light. Alas, the sea is still dead and wide, the hounds are hungered or something. We live as we live, with the mighty grief that was ours and theirs. Only we few remember it now. Arlo rests his throat and then gives a little cough to indicate he's done. It's not bad. Poetic justice. It's not bad as far as poetry goes. That's a poetic justice achievement. I don't know if it pops up for you to see as a recording from Steam. Like any good historical account, it could use more verses at the end there. Arlo laughs. Ah, you're right. It certainly could. Oh, more credits. Okay, so I guess it's kind of gone back. It gave me a little bit more extra. I still kind of want a bit more. I kind of want to know, did I strike Ivor down and he's dead? Or did I, you know, knock him unconscious? Well, I'm hoping I did. Oh, we're getting a nice song, apparently. So I guess it's taken me 44 episodes to complete Banner Saga 3 then. I believe it was 55 episodes to complete Banner Saga 2 and 59 for Banner Saga 1, if I'm not mistaken. But about 10 of the episodes of number 1 was me trying to do the final banner, couldn't win it. So that would have been a lot less. So this one actually is the shortest one. Or I'm just played 1-2 and I'm a lot better at it, so I went through a lot quicker and faster. Could also be the case. What makes sense, because I got spirit from 1 and 2, even though I haven't played them for a while. So unless there's anything else, so my ending is basically Arabin's destroyed, but most of us survived who were over there, especially the heroes and quite a few survivors, horseborn etc. There's some horseborn, there's some dredge, there's possibly some other humans maybe scattered around still. Ivor's possibly dead. Sorry, Ivan, not Ivor. Because Ivor struck him down. What's it called? Internal pain, but she's brought the dark, got rid of the darkness, brought the power back, and the light to everything. And the Raven survived, other than, of course, the main Raven leader. So I guess it's not the happiest ending in the world, but it's not the worst either. And of course, poor Rook lost his daughter and lost his love interest, but managed to help save everyone. You know, he didn't manage to save the city, unfortunately. So his goal was to save the city and save everyone. He managed to save everyone thanks to Ivor, but he didn't save the city. But he saved a lot of people's lives, so he did the best he could. Can I zoom in? Oh, I can scroll. Oh, it stops it moving doing that, though. Oh, it starts again. Oh, good. I'm just going to have a quick look at these as it goes through. Heston, PC Brazilian, which is to fight Jessica, Ivor, Liam and Abron. Guys, we did it. And which is to, oh, Kickstarter backers. I was a backer. I can't remember if I did the one from my name or not. Let's see if I am. Be like Ivan. I can't remember to put Ivan. I think put IVATOPIA, like Ivan Howard, IVATOPIA. Come on. So they're alphabetical, so either way, it'll start with I. I would like to see from there. Harry. Okay, Ivan. There I am! Woohoo! Screenshot! Ivan David Howard, IVATOPIA. I'm in the credits! Woohoo! As a backer. Nice. I mean, there's a lot of other backers. Thank you for experiencing the Banner Saga with us. Is that it? Okay. Oh, keep it together. Normal difficulty. Achievement unlocked. So is it going to be the main menu? And yeah, that's it, people. Wow, we've done it. So my overall impressions of Banner Saga then, 1, 2, and 3. 1, brilliant. 2, brilliant. 3, brilliant up until it's randomly seemed to have and didn't give me indication story why it swapped our parties over for that whole chapter and then randomly swapped them back at the end. That's the only thing I'm really putting Banner Saga 3 down on. Because to me, that kind of took me out of the story at that point. It was really an epic, and it didn't really explain the story why it did that. So, for that reason, I would say Banner Saga 3 is the worst out of the other two. But that's not by much. Like, I don't know what I would score these out of. I was going to score them. But, like, let's just say I gave Banner Saga 1 and 8, for example. And then 2, I'd probably give that maybe an 8.2. This one was probably a 7 because of that little flippy thing. They didn't do the flippy thing. I think the ending's satisfying, and that would have been a lovely 9 at least. But, you know, so. Anyway, so like, subscribe, and all that good stuff. And tune in next week for anything on my channel, because apparently this is over. Because I don't have anything else I can do with this. I don't know, watch recap, new game, load, error rate, options. Yep, they haven't added the thing like the old Banner Sagas where you could do extra survivals, it seems. So this is the end of it then. Maybe I'll go back one day and redo these again on channel. Maybe I won't. I don't know. We'll have to see. Maybe they'll bring some kind of expansion out. So they do something with the people at the end. I don't know. Well, I don't know. We'll just see how time goes. But to me, my Banner Saga is come to an end. And I did save most people on the planet. Ish. Yay, for me. So, like, subscribe. Please hit the little bell. Please check out everything else on the channel. If you didn't watch Banner Saga 1 and 2, go back and watch them. And have a great, amazing day out there. And again, if you want to put any comments about what you thought of the game itself, and what you thought of my particular playthrough of the game, and my particular story of the game, because obviously the story should vary when other people play it and what decisions you make, please put in the comments. Maybe we can have a conversation about it, I don't know. See what you got to say. If you got any questions, please put in and what your thoughts, and have a great, amazing day. And I'll quickly, before I end it, this is the 2nd of August, 2018, of me physically recording this, even this is probably going up later this year or early next year when you actually get to see it. But that's what the time I've actually date I've recorded it at 1:14 a.m. It's finished. So have a great, amazing day once again, and what a ride, what a saga. Have a great day. Bye, everyone.